Welcome to Toy Hill Studio. My name is Kendall Kessler. I put up painting demos and studio tours. And please check out my intro video. I'm very proud of that. In 2 minutes, I tell you who I am, where I come from, where I'm going, what my goals are. And I tried to do it in a humorous manner, and I think it turned out real well. Okay, if you saw the last one, you saw that I am getting back into my skyline beauty paintings, where I take various city skylines and just really have fun with the paint and try to get a really strong expression. This is San Diego, California, and I have a number of these. This will be the one I'm gonna do today will be the fifth one, and I have a number of these on my Etsy shop where there are five in each one, and a whole lot more on my website. So, last time, I had a very faraway view, and I like to just switch around, just do different things. This time, I'm going to have a close-up view, and I might do some interior stuff. There's always these bushes and things, and I might not. I'm mainly just going to play with the paint, and the skyline is the basis for it. And I've been thinking all today what I wanted to do, and I've had so many different ideas. Not been in the greatest of moods, so I thought, oh, maybe this, maybe that, I don't know. But I think what I probably am going to do is see what happens if I don't use the paint real thin. Traditionally, paint is applied thin to thick. And start out more thick and then just let it kind of move around as I add water to it. And I also wanted to pretty much stick with the cool side of the spectrum. I know I'm not going to completely stay with that. I never do. But I am going to really concentrate on that this time. And then go from there. And I don't have any kind of, gonna do this, gonna do that. I'm just really gonna see what happens. That's what I always do in these. I like to be really, really creative with these. And something comes up, I'll go with it. I already want to put some warm colors in. I'm not surprised. But it's always an adventure. And I am using it a lot thicker, so it's not going to bleed around so much. It's going to kind of stay where I put it. And then I'm going to kind of get watery. So I'm not following the traditional manner of handling paint. I am just really fooling around, just trying something a little different. And I'm kind of following the shape of that. I didn't think I was going to even do that. But it's always an experiment. If you follow my work, you know that the bulk of it is the Blue Ridge and surrounding mountains, and they're like Impressionism. I mean, they're unique to me, but if you want to put a label on them, I would say Impressionism with an expressionistic flair is basically what I do. But with these, I like to just really, really play. And as you can see, I'm always getting already into warm colors. It wouldn't last long with the cool. Already I'm starting to get something I think is very interesting. I have to spend a lot of time on social media. Oh, before I forget, I'm always forgetting. There will be a link to this painting at the top of the description at the end, and a link to my Etsy shop, my website, and other places. I'll be repeating that again, but not everybody can stay the whole time. I know it's difficult. We have so much to do. But as I was saying, I spend a lot of time on social media because that's one of the places where I promo my artwork. And I don't know about the rest of you, but I think it can be a really, really toxic place. Some of them are like people arguing and getting into fights and like, good grief. And I stay out of that. I put up my artwork and jokes. Say happy birthday, that kind of stuff. But the good thing about it is the jokes. I do get a big kick out of some of the things I see on social media. And today there is a real cute one. There was a woman and a dog, and the caption was, "How to find out which one loves you more, your wife or your dog. Put them both in a trunk, lock them in there, and an hour later, see which one is glad to see you." My husband said, "See which one doesn't bite you." Probably both. But that's a good part about social media. There are jokes, and I really look for them, and I put them up myself too, because I love to laugh. I'm very, very funny, father and a very funny husband, and it's just really great to laugh. It makes life so much better, in my opinion. And I think a lot of people get so serious. Good grief. You know, nobody's getting out of this alive. So I always wondered about people that were so concerned about having a perfect type of diet and everything. Well, you know, I care about diet too. I don't want to feel bad or get way overweight, but good grief. Some people, it's like, oh, you can't eat this, you can't eat that. Okay. Are you going to live forever because you are eating that way? And are you going to have any fun? I personally have a real bad sweet tooth. Really, really bad. And I fight with it only because I've heard that it can hurt your joints to have too much sugar. So that's the only reason I fight with it. Otherwise, I wouldn't care. But I'm one of these people that I eat to live. I don't live to eat. If I did, I would let myself really blow up. But I was a little bit overweight one time in my life. And I thought, how do people stand this? Boy, did I get rid of that. I felt like it was cutting me off when I sat down, you know, just kind of cutting my air supply off. How do people stand this? I hope I'm not insulting people out there that are a little overweight. I know it's difficult. When I was a kid, I had a lot of trouble with that. And I went to decided to try to figure out what I was doing wrong. Because I thought, you know, why do I have this problem? And it wasn't real bad. I never had a real bad problem, but it bothered me. So I went to the library and I got a nutrition book, and I figured out some things. And I figured out what I was doing wrong, stopped doing that, still love to eat and have lots of great things, and haven't had any trouble ever since. And I've people that have wondered, you know, because a lot of people tend to get heavy as they get older, have always asked me, how come, you know, you've always been skinny, you're just one of those lucky ones? No, I'm not. This is what I do, and I explain it to them, and it's really not hard to follow, but they don't want to. A lot of people just get into certain habits that are not good, and they don't want to change. They don't want to. So, you know, they ask me, so I tell them. I just don't really think it's that hard. Anyway, we need to talk about something else. I think this is coming out really nicely. I really am putting the paint down very thickly, and that's why it's not moving around. I usually really like that. I love the way water media bleeds around. That is so cool. And the last one happened a lot, and I think it turned out real well because of that. So even though this is fun, I know I'm not going to like it probably as much, because I like all that experimentation. But there's some interesting patterns going on that I really wasn't planning on that I think are turned out pretty nice. So keep on working with that. I'm getting certain planes with this kind of magenta and pink stuff, and then other planes with more blue-green. And I got some big brushes because I'm probably going to want to cover all the white. If you've watched mine, you've heard me say probably ad nauseum that white tends to fight with colors. Now, not always, but it tends to fight because white is a combination of all colors. So it's so bright, and it tends to overcome colors, even when you're using real strong colors like this. So I always like to completely cover it. Then I can see what I have much, it just is easier to see, in my opinion, what I really have here. So I'll probably take a big brush, and then I might just let it start drizzling around. I think I won't do that, because even though it's kind of cool, I really didn't want the paint to move some. So maybe I'll just take a big brush right now. It's only been 9 minutes. I like to just have these 50 minutes at most, because it just gets so long. I don't want people, you know, I'm hoping some people can go all the way through, and some people do, they tell me it's really nice. But, you know, if it's going to be 20, 30 minutes, like, good grief. Okay, I'm going to do what I did last time, where I just really kind of messed with the reflection at the same time, instead of putting it in later, which is what I usually do with ripples and reflections. I usually do that later, but in the last one, it's really kind of did that at the same time, and I thought it turned out real nice, so I think I'll do that again. 9 minutes, I better get moving. May have to be doing some of this off camera, because I'm doing it more of an involved way than I did in the last one. Alright, better move it along here. I'm not worried about any kind of exact repetition of what's there. I'm just you know, really playing around with the water. Getting ready for Christmas. I know not everybody celebrates it, but we do. And trying to get everything done and all, and in a way that it's fun and not stressful. We put up some new lights. And this time we just put up a strand, because our others weren't working, a strand of red. And I always like that, just to have one color across. And that, I think it looks really, really beautiful. We were in a new house. If you've watched these before, you know that we moved and have a new studio and everything. And trying to do things a little bit differently. We're still practically using a bulldozer to find things. I still haven't found my toolbox. I was like, oh, am I ever going to find everything? But that's okay. Real adventure. Oh, I'll never forget. Whenever I hear that word adventure, I never forget. When I was 16, long time ago, I went on a study tour to Spain. And the people in charge, teachers and all, were always telling us, if something goes wrong, we're going to see it as an adventure. So we got stuck up on a mountain and the bus broke down. And we had to, in blazing weather, come down a mountain without the bus. And of course we heard the "this is an adventure" stuff. And you know, I didn't think it was much of an adventure. Neither did my friend, who was very dehydrated and she had a problem with drinking soda. And that's all there was. There was a store at the top and we all got a soda and that's all there was. And that sort of thing made her sick. So it's like, here she is, sick from that in this wonderful adventure, climbing down. So it's hard not to think of that when I hear the word adventure. But anyway, we had a great time. It was a wonderful trip. I'll never forget it. A wonderful time. And I am reasonably fluent in Spanish. I'm trying to really get back to that because, you know, you got to use it. And I don't know any Spanish people around here. And I usually have such trouble, horrible time with accents that it's embarrassing. But I love to read. So I've been reading my Bible. I have a New Testament in Spanish, and since I've read it so many times, it's not hard. You know, I gotta look up a word here and there, but basically, it's no problem. When I was young, I used to read a lot of Unamuno. God, I read a lot of really complicated stuff then. My Spanish is not as good as it was. Voice coming along real cool now. It's not nearly as good as it was then. I've lost a lot of words and certain points of grammar, but I loved his stuff. And where are you gonna find it? I'm around here. We ain't got it. I guess I should start using interlibrary loan again, which is a great way to get books that your library doesn't have. Sometimes you have to pay for it, which I have in the past. Okay, now I'm going to try to really move this paint around so I can just cover this. If it drips into the rest, that's fine. But back to Unamuno. If you like really good short stories, you also have a lot of interesting philosophy, and well, I didn't want that to happen. Oh well, I don't want it to drip too much. Really, really great writer. One of these days I'm going to find some of his stuff again. Especially if I really get back into Spanish. I taught for 20 years at Radford University in the art department. And I used to tell people, you know, I'm in the right profession. I like to learn. I am definitely in the right profession. I like to learn. But more than that, I like to paint. I mean, I taught it, but I'm also am very serious-minded artist. This is what I do. As I always tell people, I love to paint, but I can't take them with me. So I work very hard at marketing them. And then people can buy prints too, but it's always so much better when they buy originals. That's always great. Okay, this is cool. And I think I'm about done. I'm gonna let it drip for a while and tomorrow go back into it because I wanna reestablish some things, maybe change a few things. But I've got a lot of really interesting things that I wasn't planning on, but it just happened. So I better get some of these drips up or it's going to completely drip down. And I'm just going to stop and see how it drips, because this kind of stuff's going to keep going and going until finally it's done. And last time I was going to change the drips, and I thought, no, I really like it. So I left them in and really didn't do much else to it. I might go back in and reestablish with some dark paint the buildings a little bit more. So again, thank you so much for watching. The link to the final painting, which will probably be very close to this, will be at the top of the description, link to Etsy shop, website, and other sites that have my work.